And welcome to this new video and episode from Mazigan. And here we go for our French music today and the ultimate French pop star. It's Mylène Farmer again, as I've done so already two videos about her. That was just... And it's a new video with two songs. So just before, as always, don't forget to like, share and subscribe to the channel for more videos like this. Here we go. And two songs today, one in a video, in a clip, and the other, the second one, is a live performance from Ainsi Soit-Je in Stade de France in 2K10. So just before, there will be the video. And the video is very interesting title. I just wanted to re-say to you, say it again, maybe I wasn't so clear, but I received some comment about it and a question. It's not first reaction, otherwise I will tell you in the title, first reaction. Sometimes I do first reaction for Turkish music, pop, rock music, okay. But generally it's a reaction or review. And for Mylène, I know already Mylène, it's not the first time I see, so I won't do some, oh, wow, wow. Amazing, it was and everything like this, but I want to share with you and to do some review and reaction about this incredible career that she got. So I wanted to be clear about this, and so let's get on with the song "Optimistic Moi." In English, it would be "Optimistic Me." Maybe yes, I think you could tell it as this. And this song was released in the album "Innamoramento" in 1999. The video was released maybe in 2K. I don't know, and it's including also in the best of that released quite. At the end of 2020, the best of Histoire 2. The director of the video is Michael Osman. It was not Laurent Boutonnat anymore after the failure of Giorgino in 1993. I think he wanted to make a break of doing some video. And this song was maybe the fourth single of Innamoramento, and the video was released in 2K. Okay, so it's as a spectacle. It was in a special language, maybe East European language, and it's as in a circus. You get the dwarf, and she's on thin line. The beat is really dance, Eurodance of this time. Oh, she's just almost falling. Everyone is staring at her, either laughing at her or caring for her. This song is really, really so interesting because there are many layers. The instrumentation is quite electronic. There was a big kick and a very Eurodance part of it. And also the keyboards behind, they are quite surrounding the beat that is just very present. You get some electric guitar riff that are here to make it more dynamic, more energetic, and it works very well. And above all, there is the voice of Mylène, the sweet and soft voice, crystalline voice of Mylène, that is just as a bird singing, because the melody is really, really, really nice. Many up and down and many variation in the melody. During the verse, it's almost talked and spoken, but after, the chorus is just so dramatic, big momentum. Yes, it's a highlight, it's a top view. This chorus is just infectious, and you got it stay in your head, it stay in your mind really, really long time. It was just so catchy as a song, really dancey, but the lyrics again are very, very special, very dark, and you can do some interpretation, and you can see some very, very interesting facts on the website Mylène.net. That is really, really great, and they try to give some clues about the Mylène universe and also all the references that she got. This song is really, really special, I think, in terms of lyrics. We'll see it again. We'll continue with the video. I like all the strings behind as Arabic strings in this song. Changing the verse. And background vocals from Mylène. There are so many things in this video, many related to circus, but maybe these are demons or represent all the bad thoughts of Mylène, and she's really, really observed and stared by many things around her. Maybe she's constantly hunted by someone or some people, we don't know, but I like also the beat and the structure of the song with the bass that is very repetitive as some electronic dance or house of this time, and all the different synthetic keyboards and also voice of Mylène that are so melodic, constantly melodic. And the video is something that almost scary sometimes, and I think it reflects some of her feelings. Oh, she's in cage. Oh, she thinks she's targeted. It's very hard to continue the show. This part, very high, is just so catchy. This effect can just be by Mylène, only be by Mylène, because she got the voice for it. This part is more mysterious. Great break with haunting voice behind, around, and the riff of guitar. It's a momentum, and in the video she's inside the Prestige, the magician, that maybe will make her disappear from this circus in every sense of this world. The lyrics are very intriguing. I don't know, because it's more something around incest, because she's speaking about a father. Maybe it's her father or father of a person that she know, or maybe she's just writing about this because she writes everything, all the lyrics. Maybe it was about a story, we don't know, but she talk about this father that can optimistic her and ease the pain with some caress, some words are really, really stunning and more disturbing also, because the petal humide, the wet petal, it's something that is very the rose. And it says there was two person, she's speaking to one person that is not caring about her, about what she's feeling, and the other person, the father, that is here to optimistic her. And the way he's taking care of her is something as really strong bond, and you don't know if there is a limit to this bond. The lyrics are very disturbing. I don't know, it's really, really mysterious, and I think only Milene got the answer to it, and as many songs, and all of us can go in some interpretation and searching into her universe, her literature, but I don't know. It's just so frightening. All this weapon inside the box where Milene is. She's just as desperate when she's singing Papa. Oh, where is she? She's not there. Holly Columns, great. And she's there. Also, the magician managed to make her escape. Is it a father figure? Yes, we don't know. It's something very strange again. The instrumentation with all the bass, the beat, and the guitar, saturated guitar. It's just something that is as a roller coaster that you cannot stop, and just only the keyboards and the strings and the voice of Milene, the crystalline voice, are just there to make it more human, more sensitive. It's very strange. That's why this song is just one of my favorite songs of Milene Farmer, really. After, we got another song. It's from the Stade de France live 2K10, number 5 on tour, something like this. And this live is Rêver. The song is Rêver, is dreaming. It's from the album of 1995, Anamorphosé, that was a successful, very successful album during the 90s. Rêver is one of the fans' favorite and one of the greatest success of Milene. Yvan Cassard, long time keyboard player and piano player for Milene, and arranger from 1996 tour to the Timeless tour, and also he was arranger of many many tracks and album of Milene. Everyone is crying, screaming. It's quite striking. There is just the voice of Milene. Everyone, there are 80,000 people in this stade, and nobody is saying anything. Everyone is just under the influence of Mylène. They are just hung at her lips. They are just watching her and feeling the moment, the sensibility of Mylène. There is a green laser I've seen in some bonus of the tour. He wanted to do some kind of a bubble where Mylène could reach the person. Not some big choreography, it's an intimate part of the show, and it's as a bubble with the audience and Mylène. I haven't seen something like this before, at least many times, in front of 80,000 people. You've just her in the middle, just with a piano and some note and a cappella. Your voice is just there. It's so as you are nude in front of the audience. It's really risky, I think, and she's just do it, and she gives some emotion. It's really impressive. Everyone is reacting on some words specifically. These outfits have been done by Jean-Paul Gaultier, the famous creator, of haute couture. This song is quite dark with the lyrics, but it's just as a reflection about the human, the life. But there is something as a hope, as dream, really. It's so impressive. The light is just on her. And everything around its audience. So crystalline, this voice is just so fragile and really full of melody, full of musicality. She has done some amazing progress, and she's been better and better on each live because she's working very, very intensively. And I think it's just deserving to see that she can do it really, really easily in front of so many persons. It's a slow version, slower than on the CD. She's taking her time. So much complicity with Yvonne. Everyone is knowing the lyrics by heart. That is her that is giving the tempo, and Yvonne is following his kind of adaptation, is fitting to the beat. Oh, she's so emotional. Everyone is reacting to this during many on each tour. She's just so emotive. So emotional. Everyone is reacting. She's... Ah, c'est à vous-même. It's up to you to sing. She's even nearer to her fan. She's approaching just in front of them and on her knees. Really so powerful to see this performance in front of so many people. The lyrics are again strong words. I think it's very relevant and pertinent as a reflection to the world. And you know, she's very emotional in every concert and tour. When she's doing some slow song in front of the audience as this, and the audience is singing with her or reacting, she's feeling very emotional. So sometimes she cried, sometimes she stopped to sing, and people are just covering the song at her place, and some people are just making fun of this, saying that she's doing some cinema or something like this, and some other people just feeling that she's very emotional. I'm in the second part of these people because I want to believe that she's sincere, and I think she's sincere because you can see in the song "À quoi je sers" that I was talking in this video, she has written this song after her first tour en concert in 1989, and at this time she was just not believing what's happening, what was her purpose when she was in front of the audience and the people were so into it, was so admiring her and responding to what she's singing. So she was very disturbed by this and very nervous about it, and she didn't know how to manage with this. So this kind of emotion, it seems she's getting this emotion on her different tour, and when you see the tour, you can see it's not fake because she's very into it, and it's my opinion, and this make the incredible bond that she got with the audience. No one in France in the music industry can have something like this. Johnny Hallyday was very popular and got some incredible fans. Indochine also, but Mylène Farmer's fans are just another level, I think. So emotional performance, really. People are in trance. Yes. Happy birthday. And then she's amazed. The audience is just incredible, and Yvonne is playing this melody. So it was a huge gift for Mylène's birthday. And everyone is offering this to Mylène. Happy birthday. Let's see, it's really quite a magical moment for her and for the fans that were on this tour and on this date of Stade de France. Yes, yes. Just as a little girl, she's saying that she got some 80,000 guests for her anniversary, her birthday. So it's very gentle and very nice. So that was my reaction and review. If you like this video, don't forget to like, share and subscribe to the channel for more videos like this. Tell me in the comment if you want other songs of Mylène. I will try to cover it. And also you can go to mylène.net, a really, really nice website and forum also. Take care of you and of your relatives. It's so important in this period. You can listen listening to Every Million Farmers album and CD, live performance, single, songs, in CD, in streaming and in video, of course. And I hope you're doing well and see you very, very soon. So take care. Bye.